little bit of the action from the first two games of this Western Conference quarterfinal series in Nashville. The series shifts here to Joe Louis Arena as we take a look at our McDonald's I'm Loving It spotlight, and it focuses on the two goaltenders in this series and their work so far. Arena was much busier in game one in the victory than he was in game two in defeat, when Detroit had only 17 shots on goal after having 37 in the first game. Jimmy Howard, pretty special in game one, although he lost, made some big saves as well in game two. There you see his total numbers so far in this series. Dave Strader in the booth. Brian Engblom is our man between the benches inside the glass. And game three between the Predators and the Red Wings underway, and the stick snaps right away. It's Radulov's stick. Going to mention right away, same lineup for the Detroit Red Wings as they had in game two. Of course, they lost Darren Helm in game one for the rest of the series. Couple of lineup changes for the Nashville Predators. Still no Hal Gill, but Ryan Ellis is in on defense. Here's a chance off for Lightline, and the Detroit native, who would love to have scored early here at the Joe, is stopped by Jimmy Howard.
And it starts from the forecheck again of Nashville. Nashville was really good last game on the forecheck and turning pucks over.
Andre Kostitsyn sends it back to the line. Here's Weber with a wrist shot, and that was deflected by Lightline and bounces right in on Howard.
David Leguan's got lots of experience for Nashville, more than anybody else. He's an original Predator, but they get in deep and they turn pucks over. Good job by Radulov to get in, get some speed going, and then Leguan's the high man. He comes in off the wall, gets a terrific centering pass, and that's a real quality scoring chance early on here for Nashville. But Jimmy Howard picking up where he left off in game two. Howard reading the play, making a terrific save on Leguan.
Just to finish the lineup thoughts there, Ryan Ellis in for Jack Hillen on defense, and Jordan Tutu is in for Matt Halaschuk on the forward line. As it comes to the high slot, a shot here by Fisher, and that was grabbed by Howard. So, Brian, a good start here for the road team Nashville Predators, early pressure.
Yeah, and this is a tough building to play in, there's no doubt about that. Detroit wanted some energy. Nick Lidstrom talked about that in the interview, but so far, the energy all belongs to Nashville. They spent the opening shift inside the zone, turning pucks over. That's the second shot on net. They're going to try and throw as much rubber as they can on Jimmy Howard.
Faceoff win leads to another shot toward the net by Klein that goes wide. Bertuzzi has it roll off his stick. Now it is jammed along the boards. Crowd appreciating the physical play. Down behind Jimmy Howard. It's poked at by Sergei Kostitsyn. And now Datsyuk being pressured there by Fisher and then given a rough ride into the boards. But Detroit comes out with it. Here's Erickson leading the rush. Winds up and drives one in on Pecorine, who has it on the glove and is forced to hold it there.
You know, when you look at the Nashville Predators and you talk about, well, they didn't have enough offense last game and they were 0 for 6 again on their power play, Nashville generated a lot of offense. They did a lot of good things. Martin Irat couldn't find the back of the net. Suter didn't have that many shots on goal. But you know what? The forwards, the top two lines of Nashville, although they didn't come up with much on the score sheet, they generated time after time after time. And they know they can put Detroit in trouble in their own zone. They've shown it here early.
Gostad wins the draw. It's sent all the way down the ice. It would have been icing, but it was played there by Jimmy Howard. Now a shot from the line is blocked by Drew Miller, who is racing after this loose puck. Weber trying to get the angle. A backhand shot. Collision with Pecorine, and there's going to be a penalty here. Which way are they going to call this? Interference.
Looks like they're calling Drew Miller. Drew Miller's got some great speed. He played a terrific game in game two. The third and fourth lines for Detroit were really good. They turned the tables on Nashville. And this loose puck, it was a bad shot by Suter. He shot it right into Miller. Weber had to come across, and Drew Miller drives the net. And we see that a lot. You know what? I agree with that call. I don't have a problem with it. Miller definitely drove the net hard. If he had to, if he wanted to, he could have stopped up a lot shorter than that. He makes contact with the goaltender. He was not pushed in by Shea Weber. I like that call.
Well, a minute and 35 into game number three, a problem that has been there since the start of this series for Mike Babcock's team. They've just been in the penalty box too often, this Nashville power play. We've mentioned it, number one in the league during the regular season, 0 for 12. And Brian, that is the worst two-game stretch for this Nashville power play the entire season.
Yeah, there's no doubt about that, Dave. I mean, you know, the numbers speak for themselves there. But at the same time, I don't think Nashville can get too carried away with those numbers. They generated a lot of chances on the power play. Yes, they didn't score, and that's got to change. But I don't think they're feeling bad about themselves.
Weber with a shot that trickles in toward Howard. He steered it aside. And Emerton starts it back the other way. Ole Emerton, who had a goal in the game, a 2-victory down at Bridgestone Arena in Nashville as we're 2 minutes into this game three. Now Suter dumps it along the boards behind Howard. Bounces it, puck, Barnwell gets there. Predators play it up the boards now. Weber, right point. Booed every time he touches the puck now. Now it comes back to Weber again. Shovels it along for Andre Kostitsyn. He sends it down low, quickly whipped out high. Here is Weber with a drive, and that broke the stick of the penalty killer for Detroit, Datsyuk. Now a wraparound try. Howard was down, and it's cleared back to the line, and Suter has it there. Just under a minute remaining in the Drew Miller minor penalty. Here is Legwand, who's had a couple of chances already in this game. Backhanded to the front, a shot saved by Howard. Loose puck, they score! That was jammed home to the right of Howard after he made the initial stop. Brian, he could not pick up the puck on this rebound.
I'm not sure who ended up getting credit. I think it's Radulov off to the side of the net. It was blocked out down here a little bit, but really good puck movement. Detroit was at a disadvantage for sure because Datsyuk had his stick broken in half by the shot by Shea Weber. So they start adjusting a little bit. Nashville will get the puck to the net. You got Kostitsyn down low and Radulov. There's the initial shot and a nice save by Jimmy Howard. And then it looks like it might be Shea Weber.
Yep.
Shea Weber jumped in from the point. He gets the rebound on that short side. Kostitsyn battling in front. Detroit defensemen and defenders in general didn't know where the puck was. And before they can find it, Shea Weber finds it. So the guy who was getting booed, the villain for Nashville, scores the first goal.
His second of the series and 10th career playoff goal. And Nashville gets their first power play goal of the series. Now Zetterberg battling with E-Rattle on the near boards. Filppula comes in. The puck comes free and Lidstrom has it for Detroit. Slides it across. And as Erickson tried to get it in deep, he lost his balance. And Lidstrom back inside the Detroit end, able to regroup here now as the Red Wings looking to come out of their own zone. Here is Filppula gains the line. Predators back in good position defensively. Rink wide now for Zetterberg. He turns, wheels it across, but it's knocked down by Bouillon. He'll play it off the boards out of the reach of Hornquist. And it's covered up here for the whistle. Well, expand your hockey experience with the Verizon StarCam on NBCSports.com and NHL.com. Throughout the game, we're streaming a live ISOCam following star players like Pavel Datsyuk and Shea Weber. There are others, of course. The Verizon StarCam is available now at NBCSports.com and NHL.com. Andre Kostitsyn and Alexander Radulov, the assist on the goal by Weber. As Cleary starts it back the other way and pushes it deep. Nyquist in on the forecheck. There was Ryan Ellis. First shift, I believe, for him. In the Stanley Cup playoff game, spinning away is Nyquist. He puts it in front. Cleary was there! And Wiene got the right pad on it. Now Cleary trying to stay in the crease area. Roughed up by a Nashville player, but the Predators come back the other way, and this shot is blocked. The loose puck in front for Spalling goes up just over top of the net. Now Gabriel Bourque, who had a couple of goals in game one, could not control this as the Wings were able to clear. And here is Ryan Ellis, who played his junior hockey just across the river in Windsor, where he had a spectacular junior career.
Well, Nashville certainly doesn't look like a team that's rattled by giving up home ice advantage and splitting at home. They've really taken it to the Wings here early.
That's it. Back to the late man. Cronwall gets the shot away. It's knocked down by Rene and up the near side. Cronwall there again. Runs into Radulov. Now Bertuzzi gathering the puck against Shea Weber, but it's knocked away here by Radulov and sent back into the Detroit zone. This will be icing against Nashville.
Chances at both ends of the ice. Nyquist did a nice job. That third, fourth line group that did a real nice job last game for Detroit. There's Nyquist taking it to the front of the net. Dan Cleary just can't get a handle on it. Real nice job by Bourque coming back for some support there. Cleary getting position there. That's a lot of good playoff hockey there. You push off and you create some room. And then at the other end of the ice coming back, Spalling doing a nice job of getting the puck through, staying with it, and getting that second chance from in tight. Third and fourth lines have been the story in many ways in this two-game series so far. In the first game, it was Nashville with their third and fourth lines that had an impact, and in Detroit in game two.
Well, Zetterberg steps into the faceoff circle here against Legwan. The team that has scored first in the first two games of the series has gone on to win. Nashville has the first goal here as Lidstrom takes a hit, plays it up the far side, and Erickson now just one hands it out to center ice. Filppula with Hudler. Two on two. Filppula's shot is collected by Pecorine. He will hold it there as we go inside the glass, presented by Progressive Insurance. Here's Brian.
We've talked about the guy in the eye of the storm is Shea Weber, and I listened to Keith Jones yesterday in the studio talk about the fact that he hasn't been quite up to par, and you know what? I agree with Keith. I think Weber's been good, he's been solid, but this guy is like Zdeno Chara. He's got a presence about him, and he has to elevate just a little bit. He was just a tad off. His presence on the ice has been muted just a little bit. Maybe with this goal early in the game here, it'll change, because he's not like every other guy out there. He's mean, he's nasty, he established that early in this series for sure, and I don't think he's going to mind the pressure at all. The fans booing him here at the Joe Louis Arena.
Now Gossett sends his puck in deep. Here is Yip, Jordan Tutu, his first shift of the series. He'll bring energy, he'll bring a physical presence, and he brings a pass to the point that leads to a great scoring chance by Klein, and he just missed the net.
Sometimes when you had that much time, it's too much time. Klein took too long. He had a great scoring chance. That's got to get through.
Roman Josi backing up. Hands it off to his partner, Klein, far side. It's deflected by Yip deep into the Detroit zone as both teams look to make changes here. 6 minutes gone by, game three of this Western Conference quarterfinal series that is tied at a game apiece. Filppula back to the line, and that's going to be brought in offside. The series is tied at a game apiece, but Shea Weber, the villain here in Detroit, has the first goal of game three. It's 1-0 Nashville here in the Motor City. Well, the Stanley Cup playoffs continue on the networks of NBC Universal right here on NBC today at 3 Eastern. Game 3 of that terrific Eastern Conference quarterfinal series between Pittsburgh and Philly. And two more games tonight on the NBC Sports Network. Jersey and Florida, their game 2. The Devils lead that series 1-0. That starts at 7:30 Eastern. And then Vancouver at Los Angeles. LA won the first two games of that series on the road. That's coming your way at 10:30 Eastern tonight on the NBC Sports Network. What a start to the Stanley Cup playoffs league-wide. Again, the home team just 5-10. 5 wins, 10 losses in the first 15 games of the 2012 playoffs.
We talked about that last game, Dave, and you know what? Home ice advantage for me happens in game 7. Early on in the series, the way hockey is played, there isn't as big an advantage. Sometimes it turns against you, as a matter of fact. But game 7, you want to be home.
Now here is Hudler with it, drops it back for Lidstrom. Lidstrom far side, and Hudler took a hit as he dumps it along the boards in behind Pecorine. Filppula, Zetterberg working down low against Weber and Suter. Zetterberg knocked down, jumps back up, still protecting the puck against Suter, who's just trying to lean on him. Zetterberg able to get it to the front, gets it to the forehand, centering pass, missed the stick of Hudler. Goes all the way out to the right point, Erickson. Hudler back to Erickson on the give and go. Good stop there by Rene. Well executed cycle here by Detroit. They still have control in the Nashville zone.
That was smart by Erickson. How and when he moved in, Hornquist lost track of him for a second. And great scoring chance.
Lidstrom sent it wide. Here is Hudler again. Didn't get much on the centering pass, and now it's cleared ahead for the Predators at center ice. And Sergei Kostitsyn just dumps it back in deep. The first one to get to it, though, is going to be Hornquist. He overskates it. Now he's checked by Stewart. And it's Ian White, who opened the scoring in game 2. Given a bump by Gabriel Bork, who just came off the bench. Now Ellis with a shot. That was knocked down in front. And Cleary able to play it ahead for Nyquist. Nyquist wanted to get it behind Ellis. He failed to do that. Now Cleary across the line. Cleary with a first shot. Easy glove stop there for Pecorine.
Jonathan Erickson, not known for his offense. He's known more for his defense, but it was smart play moving in. Nice give and go. Gives it to Hudler. Jumps by Hornquist. Hornquist feels him moving, but still, the execution on the play by Hudler to get it right on his tape gives a real good scoring chance to Jonathan Erickson. And you know what? For Erickson, he had more ice time than anybody on the Detroit Red Wings in game two. That would surprise a lot of people. It surprised me when I looked it up. He has been really valuable for them, especially on the penalty kill. And with all the penalties in this series so far, he's gotten a lot more confidence because of he blocks a lot of shots. He's got a real good reach and a real good read for the game inside his zone. If he can add a little offense, that would be great for Detroit.
Erickson missed 13 games down the stretch with an injury for Detroit.
And his coach said, Dave, that when they missed him for that time, it was about a month that he missed.
Yep.
Their penalty kill went down to around 71%, which is horrible. When he came back, it was no coincidence that they've been brilliant since.
Yeah, because his injury coincided largely with the Jimmy Howard injury with the broken finger.
That's so true, yeah.
Two tough guys to lose on your penalty kill. Datsyuk sends it across. Bertuzzi with a chance. Fired just wide as Franzen went to the front of the net. And back comes Nashville now. They decide late in the shift they're just going to dump it in. As Stewart gets to it. Challenged by Legwan up the far side. Wing's able to clear, but here's Suter across for Weber. Again, no Hal Gill yet in this series for Nashville. Here is Legwan. Now it comes to Radulov. He didn't miss by much. Another penalty coming on Detroit on that rush. Oh, excuse me. Now let's see what this whistle is. Was it an early substitution for the
yes.
goalie going off?
Yes. That's what they're claiming there. Barry Trotz not very happy, but the linesmen were right on top of it there. They didn't like the substitution. That's the argument going on right now, and they missed an opportunity to get an extra guy out. But Cronwall is the man going in the penalty box. Nashville has moved the puck really well inside the blue line. That's got to be a concern for Mike Babcock. Leg one on the attack. Radulov will end up getting a pass and a pass from Kostitsyn, and he lets it go right away. And the hooking call by Cronwall. All the moving pieces are in fact moving in different directions for Nashville, and that's caused problems for Cronwall and the defense.
Yeah, interesting, Brian. Both games in this series, the losing team has come out saying, you know what, we liked a lot of what we did. And Detroit felt pretty good about their game despite the loss in game one. And Nashville, especially talking to Barry Trotz this morning a couple of hours before puck drop, was very happy with the way his team played, limiting Detroit to 17 shots. And coaching staffs, as you know, Brian, keep track of scoring chances a little differently. But basically, Barry Trotz confirmed what we all thought. More chances for Nashville than Detroit in that second game, although the Predators end up losing. Here was Suter. Watched by Cleary. Now Cleary got a stick on it, but the Predators regain. Suter and Weber switching sides. Now Erat hands it off down low. They jam it to the front. It's picked up now for Erat. A shot. I'm not sure if that was Howard that stopped it or whether it was Brad Stewart. They both were there.
It looked like Stewart from here, but what puck movement by Nashville. There was nothing. Fisher faked the shot and got it over to Erat. They generate a lot. Now this Fisher line was a line that got stymied time and time again. Again in game two, couldn't score, but they got a lot of confidence obviously here.
Two Predators, two Red Wings on the puck. Now a couple of more players join the fray. As we're down to 40 seconds remaining on the Cronwall hooking minor, the puck comes out to Ellis right point. Hands it off now to Radulov. Back to Ellis, fakes the one-timer, lost control. Datsyuk able to clear it. Race for the puck here. Miller trying to split the Nashville players. And it's poked away by Pekkarinne. Good job by the two Nashville players not to take a penalty. Here come the Predators again. Centering pass, and Andre Kostitsyn just missed slamming it home at the side of the net. Now Josi. Straight away for Ellis. Hands it off now to Legwan. Legwan looking down low. Hits it there to Radulov. Radulov circles the net, plays it back out. Here is Ellis. Off the stick of Datsyuk. He'll chase it down and carry it out with Cronwall coming out of the box. Coming off the bench is Scopola. He'll get the drop pass. It goes back to Datsyuk. That's it across now for Lidstrom. He hammers a shot that's knocked down. Goes straight out to White. And that went off the glass. Still in play though. Here's Scopola. Lidstrom across for White. Back to Lidstrom. Scopola angles it off the end boards. Fiddler couldn't get to it. Zetterberg has it. Now it comes back to White. White looks across. And Lidstrom let it go, and it's spun out to center ice. Red Wings would have been offside if they touched that puck, so Ryan Ellis has it now for the Predators for Kevin Kline. Fiddler going in and put on some pressure. A giveaway here, though. Ellis, good job to get in front of Emerton. Now Bork with it. Ends it around the board. Big hit behind the Nashville net by Johan Franzen as this puck rolls in wide of Howard. Is it going to be icing? A race for it. And the icing call is made. Sports Group brings you unprecedented coverage of the first jewel of the Triple Crown, the 138th running of the Kentucky Derby. Coverage begins May 2nd on the NBC Sports Network and continues race day May 5th on NBC. This is the year we finally get another Triple Crown winner. Hasn't happened since the mid-70s. Now Bork on the far side chops at it. Gostad and Spalling now, and Spalling able to get it back to Bork at center ice. It's flipped ahead. That hit Gostad, and the play is offside. The visiting Nashville Predators lead 1-0 in game three. Let's go to Brian Engblom for our Kia Motors coach interview with Detroit Red Wings head coach Mike Babcock.
Mike, you said in game two there were times you didn't like the way your team played defensively. How do you like the way they're playing right now?
Well, I didn't like the way we started. We lost four faceoffs in a row, and then we ended up under pressure. And we gave up the one chance, I thought, where we got run around in our own zone. But we started to come a little bit. We've been shorthanded twice. The first one was a penalty, and the second one, holy God. But anyway, we got to go from here. We've given up a power play goal when we broke a stick. We got to get after them in their own zone here a bit.
Thanks, Mike.
Thank you.
Yeah, they lost four draws in a row, and so far they've lost 11 of 14. Make that now a 12-3 advantage in the faceoff department for the Nashville Predators. They've won 12 out of 15 draws here.
That's really seesawed back and forth in the series.
It has. It's been big advantage Nashville and a big advantage Detroit. Deflected right in front of Howard. Played off the far boards, and it's poked out to center ice by the Predators. And Klein able to hand it back now.
Nashville's really going to the paint, Dave. We always say in the playoffs, if you spend your time looking for open space, you're going to lose. There isn't any open space. If you don't want to go into the hard areas, then it's not going to happen for you. Nashville's going there.
Penalty coming against the Predators as Bilfila made a nice little move at the blue line to stay onside and then was taken down.
David Legline going for a trip here. So for a chance for Detroit to get some momentum going. Even if they don't score on this power play, puck possession is something that they specialize at. There's David Legline turning around and sweeping. That was a good move by Bilfila drawing the penalty here. But for Detroit, their game is about puck possession, about dominating the ice surface here at Joe Louis Arena. They haven't been able to do that so far in this first period. It's been all Nashville. Now they have a chance on the power play.
Red Wings 2-for-10 so far in this series. Both of the goals coming in the game one loss. Here is Lindstrom with it. Slides it across Cromwell. Hands it off Datsyuk. Holmstrom setting up in his usual spot in front of Pekarinen. Lindstrom fires it just wide. Intensely comes off the end board. Kicked around behind the end line, and now Josi for the shorthanded Predators sends it all the way down the ice.
That's something that Nashville's going to have to get adjusted to. The end boards here are about 10 times more lively than they are in Nashville, and Detroit uses them very effectively.
Holmstrom plays it around. Rene read that play and stopped it, tried to clear it himself. It's blocked on the far side, and Pavel Datsyuk has it again. Datsyuk takes a look, hands it off down low. It's jammed to the front. Poked out to the line by one of the Red Wings. I think it was Holmstrom, but he missed Cronwall with it. Now the Predators will quickly change their penalty killing. On the rush, Zetterberg had it knocked away. Good keep in by Datsyuk. Here's Cronwall. Datsyuk taking down a shot here, and where does it end up? I think Pekarinen has it in his glove. He does.
That last play by Detroit was sort of one where you make eye contact with the players on your team, and then it's a timing pattern. It went from Datsyuk to Zetterberg down in the corner, and then boom, they swept it right to the front of the net. Holmstrom knows it. He can feel the play coming. They were trying to hit his stick and go for that quick jam play. But Nashville and Pekarinen especially doing a nice job there in the paint. And Holmstrom is a big load for Pekarinen to deal with because Holmstrom is always on the edge of that paint. Now that Holmstrom is off, it'll be Johan Franzen will take a spot in front.
Faceoff win again by the Predators. Puck, though, held in by White at the right point. Here is Franzen. Hands it. Well, he was going to. Now he gives it to Bilfila. He'll go to the front of the net. Franzen will to take his normal spot. Now Hudler. Pushed to the boards by Weber. Goffalo. Aerial pass out to White, and it jumped over the blade of his stick. The 35 seconds remaining in the leg one penalty. Nashville with a 1-0 lead in this series that is tied at one game apiece. Weber comes up with it, plays it around on the far side. Bouncing puck, Filippula able to get it back out to Franzen. Final 20 seconds of the power play to the front of the net. Backhanded by Hecker, and it's covered up by Pekarinne.
I think Suter got a stick on that, but it was Hudler with a chance down low. Pekarinne ends up making the save and covering up, but Suter tracks the play really well. When Hudler moves, he moves. We'll see who ends up finally making the save on. Look at Hudler there. Suter comes across. Hudler just didn't get the shot that he wanted, but it was because Suter was moving across on him so well. You have to sort it out. It looks like it goes off of Suter's leg, and then Pekarinne with that huge wingspan is able to get out there. The interesting thing for Nashville, they acquired Hal Gill, of course, to help them out on the penalty kill, and he was terrific. They had to get used to him. Now they have to get used to being without him.
Bertuzzi sends it across. White sends it far side to the net, just wide. Off the stick of Zetterberg. And Leguan is out of the box. Puck still in the Nashville zone. White shot hits the stick of Zetterberg, goes to the far side. Now Klein, pushed by Bertuzzi. Radulov sends it across. Here's Erat now for Leguan. Carries into the Detroit zone. Leguan looks across, now sends it to the front. Howard sweeps it aside. Abel Datsuk for the Wings. Pulls it back. Goes down to Erickson. Off the stick of Stewart and collected by the Predators. Dumped to center ice. Fisher hands it off to Radulov across the line. Challenged by Stewart, who did a good job with his stick and his skate. Now Yossi across the line. Sends it back in deep. Sergei Kostitsyn. Pressured there by Stewart all the way to the boards. It's dumped back behind Howard. Just over 4 minutes remaining here in the first period. Shots are 10-8 Detroit, but it doesn't feel that way. Here is Cleary now. Puts on the brakes, goes down. Taken away. Abdelkader. Sends it to the corner for Nyquist. Now Nyquist turns, sends it back in deep. Cleary. Had it roll off his stick. Fisher able to get it out to center ice. Recovered here by Detroit. Cronwall for Abdelkader. Former Michigan State star tried to get a shot away. That was blocked. Abdelkader up the boards with it. Knocked off his stick and sent it just wide. Ellis taken to the boards by Nyquist. Now Bork will start it back the other way for Nashville. Bork with some speed to the outside. His shot into the glove of Howard, and he holds it there. 3:20 to go in the first. Nashville continues to lead by one. Time now for our John Hancock pivotal moment. Brian, it came after the final horn in game one.
Shea Weber and Zetterberg at the end of game one, and then in game two, the collision between Bertuzzi and Weber and the quick, we want to go, okay, they both settled it. I went to Todd Bertuzzi, or tried to talk to him about that, just exactly what was said, did you say anything? And Todd didn't want to talk about it. He said, you know what, we've just moved in here, I admire the professionalism of that. Both those guys know exactly what playoffs are about, not a big deal, it's done and over with.
Kind of the same response you got from Shea Weber when you asked him about being the villain. He didn't even want to go back in time at all. These players just want to look forward.
Yeah, whatever's in front of you, that's the way to do it. You have to deal with what's in front of you all the time. You try to recreate something else or worried about something that happened before, that's no good. But Dave, we're in this game three now of the series, and this is where it starts to really get good, any series, because you play two games against each other. The feel factor is really intense. You feel like you know everybody on the other team extremely well. You know their moves. It's heated up. That's the great thing about the playoffs. Now it's about adjustments and trying to beat each other one-on-one.
White shot is blocked by Tutu. He wheels it out to center ice, and a diving play by White broke up what may have been a pretty good rush there by Klein and Yip. But now the Red Wings back behind their own net as both teams making changes. Under 2.5 remaining in the first period. That pass over the stick of Franzen now as Suter plays it back center ice for the Predators. Erat for Weber. Lobs it back to the far side. Here's Fisher. Colliding there with Stewart. Fisher was ready for that hit. Johnson flips it back now into the Nashville zone. Rene settles it down for Weber. And Weber lifts it out to center ice, blocked by Stewart. And
the hero from game one of this series was the rookie Gabriel Bourque. And on Bourque's last rush and his last shift out, watch the speed here. He looks into the middle, doesn't have anybody. I really liked that shot. Even though he was a long ways away, you know what? It was all Jimmy Howard could handle. And I think Howard looked at him and had that recognition factor like, okay, this kid can shoot. What made it significant is he shot it while his feet were still moving and he didn't telegraph it and he got a lot on it. That could have surprised Jimmy Howard. Howard was sharp.
Wasn't sure what that whistle was for, Brian. They called a hand pass, and Brad Stewart was telling the linesman it didn't hit his hand, but the official said yes, it did. That's why they stopped play, as Stewart now will drive this puck into the Nashville zone, but that play is offside with a minute 34 now remaining here in the first period.
Playoff games are all about momentum. Barry Trotz knows that. His team is more well-equipped than ever. He's played the Detroit Red Wings in playoff series twice before. They lost both times in six games. But he knows, and he has said out loud, that this team is more well-rounded. It is better prepared, and therefore it means that they have more offense and more confidence that they can control those momentum swings and try to get puck possession away from Detroit. So far, they've sawed it off over the last couple of minutes. Detroit was on their heels in the early stages, and that power play did help their puck possession game a little bit.
Erickson dumps his puck deep, gets to it first, pokes it near side for Filppula. Now Zetterberg. Had to duck away from Josi, but Josi played him well. Now Radulov has to go back into his own zone, slides it across, Josi. Now for Klein, he wanted to redirect it deep, but it was blocked, and Hudler drops it back for Zetterberg. Zetterberg across the line. Takes it wide on Josi, lost control for a moment. Now sends it back toward Pecorino, who had to steer it aside with that right pad. Rattled off around the boards, and it's taken back in front of the Red Wing bench by Jonathan Erickson.
There's a lot more emotion here now, too, Dave. There's a lot more yakking between the two teams.
Now it is sent back all the way down behind Jimmy Howard. This is going to be icing against Nashville. Stay tuned for the first intermission coming up with Liam McHugh and Mike Milbury talking about Shea Weber responding and desperate Pens visit Philly. What a game three. That's going to be coming up on NBC with the Pennsylvania rivalry ratcheted up with the road team Flyers not only winning but having to come from behind in both of those games in Pittsburgh.
Wild games. All the skill level in that series really coming through. 13 goals scored the other night.
Now Cronwall slides at center right. That's picked off and carried in just offside as the Predators were scrambling to.
Suter surprised Todd Bertuzzi there. That was a good read by Suter. Suter wants a penalty there. He thought Bertuzzi pulled his feet out from underneath him.
Yeah.
Bertuzzi saw Suter sliding in. He was backing away from the puck and went, oops, I got to get in there. He did. Put a stick over top of Suter. That's the long pass that didn't have much on it. You see
Suter moving
up on the play there. Real good read by Suter. That's an aggressive frame of mind for Nashville.
Suter's got a good point, though. You can read his lips with the referee. Said, how did I fall down? I had the puck, and all of a sudden I went down. Now Cleary sends it on the far side. Datsyuk, couple of moves. Sends it across to Cronwall. Final seconds of the first period. Puck rolls in wide of Rene. Taken there by Fisher. He'll take a hit as he clears it back out to center ice. And the first 20 minutes of game three will come to an end. And there's your goal scorer, Shea Weber. And it came on the power play, the first power play goal in this series for the Nashville Predators after going 0 for 12 in the first two games in Nashville. 1-0 Predators at the end of 20 minutes of play. Stay with us. The first intermission coming up with Liam McHugh and Mike Milbury on the other side of this. And welcome back to the Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Getting ready for the start of the second period of Game 3 of the Western Conference Quarterfinal Series in the Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by Geico. Let's go inside the glass with Brian Engblom.
Dave, I was really impressed in that first period with this Nashville Predators team. They set the tone early on. Their forecheck was outstanding. They've had Detroit in trouble several times in the last two games, really, because of that ability to get in, use that speed and that quickness, and generate some scoring opportunities. That's something that Detroit's going to have to fix. Look early on. That was leg one in the very first shift of the game with a point-blank scoring chance. Nashville going to the tough areas. That was on the power play. And then the goal for Weber moving in at the last second. And it ended up, it's funny on that goal too, because Pavel Datsyuk had broken his stick on that power play goal. And then Brad Stewart had broken his stick right at the last second too. So you had two Detroit Red Wings with no sticks when Weber actually ended up whacking it into the net. So the onus is on Detroit here. They're down by one in this building that they normally dominate. And we'll look for them to get their puck possession game back.
They were 31-7-3. The 65 points they had on home ice was tied with St. Louis for the best in that category, but as we pointed out, home ice advantage has meant virtually nothing so far in the first round of these playoffs. Second period is underway with Datsyuk controlling the draw. Lidstrom and Erickson, the defense tandem to start off here for Mike Babcock, Datsyuk, Bronson Bertuzzi. The forward line as it's poked away. Harry Trott starting with the leg one rattle off Andre Kostitsyn line, and his top tandem of Suter and Weber. As Franzen into the zone, wrist shot is blocked up on the netting, over the glass and out of play.
Last game, I thought Johan Franzen was outstanding. He was a force. And it started because he started the game angry. He and Mike Fisher got into it in their very first shift of the game. Fisher got his elbow up and his stick up on Franzen. This was the very first shift. Franzen's angry. Look at him. He's coming back up the ice. Later on the same shift, he snaps his stick across the arm of Fisher. That's what he looked like shortly afterwards. He ended up scoring the game-winning goal. But Franzen was good all night long. We haven't noticed him as much yet here this afternoon.
And Franzen used to scoring game-winning goals in the playoffs. Last six playoff years, the most game winners, 12, of any player in the National Hockey League. He was absolutely terrific in 08 and 09, the 08 Cup winning year, and 09 losing in Game 7 of the finals to Pittsburgh.
Well, what makes him so good, Dave, is he doesn't look for open spaces. He goes right to the front of the net. He bangs and crashes, goes to the hard area because he's a big man and he is strong. That's why they call him Mule.
Al Filppula wheels it back in deep. Zetterberg out front with a shot, and Pecorine just held his ground as that puck thumped off the left pad. Now it comes back to the line for Ian White, trying to change the shooting angle. The puck was deflected by Yip to the far corner. Now the two players and an official go down, but the referee that's out at center ice has got a call here, and I believe it's against Jordan Tutu.
Jordan Tutu in the lineup for the first time in this series. A healthy scratch. He's not injured. He wasn't playing very well down the stretch, quite frankly. So they took him out of the lineup, and I saw his coach talking to him the other day, trying to get him fired up and ready. A little poke in the back. That's just pretty smart play by Zetterberg. That's an experienced move. He knows he's who he's playing against. Zetterberg had Tutu stick under his arm. Yes, he did. And Tutu got angry and punched him in the back of the head. That's not what Barry Trotz wants from Jordan Tutu.
Played all but four games in the regular season, had a two-game suspension early on, and was a healthy scratch a couple of times, Brian, down the stretch. As you mentioned, he just wasn't playing well, but it had to be a huge disappointment for him to not start
for sure.
Playoffs. And during the off-day skate between games one and two, Barry Trotz spent a lot of time on the ice with Jordan Tutu, just talking with him. As Franzen with a shot here on a save made by Rene. Franzen tried to go across the body of the big Finnish goaltender. Now it's out in front, controlled by neither team, but Datsyuk digs it out. Cromwell with a drive. Not sure what that hit in front. All kinds of traffic there with Franzen and Holmstrom there. But Spaulding for the Predators comes up with it, sends it all the way back down the ice.
Nashville came back to the house really well there and jammed things up, but Datsyuk walking out of the corner put them in trouble. They just couldn't put it in.
Now Lidstrom hands it off for Zetterberg, gains the zone. And not what he wanted to do with that pass, certainly, and the Predators able to clear.
Detroit is really good at taking the zone, boy. Whether it's Datsyuk or whether it's Lidstrom, two of the best in the game. They make the right pass all the time at the right time, and they gain entry.
Another good example of it there. They gain the zone with speed. Now they're able to get it back and set things up. Kyle Quincy Akpomfilpola gets a shot that changes direction and goes just wide. And Fisher able to backhand this one all the way down the ice.
Forcing those one-timers when the pass is not where it's supposed to be, that wasn't a good idea for Quincy.
Now Quincy again slides it across. Here comes Zetterberg. Good job by Spaulding. That's the way to break up the Detroit entry.
Spaulding's reads are so good. His positioning is good. He starts to figure out when you play a series, you start to see the repetitive patterns. And he had an idea of what Zetterberg wanted to do and turned it over.
Now Hudler, broken up. And the Red Wings forced back inside their own line. And Jordan Tootoo getting set to come out of the box. And he has the puck now and deflects it into the Detroit zone. Erickson back to get it. Tootoo staying on him. Now Cleary able to get it to Valtteri Filppula, back for Cleary up the left side. Takes it wide. Has to put it in the feet of Pecorine. It's cleared around the board by Klein, and it is taken by Erat. Gives it back. What a move here by Klein. He's hooked. He scores! Kevin Klein has both goals for the Nashville Predators has come from their defense, and they lead it 2-0.
What a brilliant move by Klein, but this is all about speed. He's coming from behind just a little bit, but the speed is overpowering. He only has to make one smooth move with the puck, but then he has to finish, of course. Speed has been a big part of the game here on the attack for Nashville. Really nice job there as Stewart gets caught moving from his right to his left there. Doesn't realize that Klein is coming from behind. He hooks him a little bit. There was actually going to be a penalty on Stewart for that little hook. But there won't be any time in the penalty box for Stewart because Klein has hands like a 40-goal scorer on that one. Brilliant work, Kevin Klein.
Second career playoff goal, and that's hard to believe when you see a play like that, isn't it?
Yeah, no doubt. You know what, the thing about the National Hockey League is not always the puck carrier is the most dangerous guy. It's the guy who's moving the fastest is the most dangerous because he'll get the puck sooner than later, and Klein got it with great speed. Stewart was caught with not much backward momentum. As soon as he made his move to his left, he was toast.
So on the heels of a penalty kill by Nashville, they get a goal to give them a 2-0 lead. Gabriel Bourque pressured there by Cleary. Now Leguan. It rolls out to the line. Bouillon with a shot that is steered aside by Howard, and it's up the near side where Bourque swipes at it again to keep it in momentarily for Nashville. And now White will send it out to center ice. Nyquist is there now for Cleary. Cleary waiting for the defense change, just coming off the bench. Here's a shot, a left pad saved by Rene. Well, I don't think he saw that puck off the stick of Brad Stewart.
No, I don't think he did either, but he's so tall, his legs are so long at 6'5", he takes away the whole bottom part of that net.
Stewart rushes it right back up, Rene the save. Bertuzzi slides it right back to the blue paint. It's recovered on the near side by Andre Kostitsyn. And back the other way, Radulov. Swept off of his stick, and now he's knocked off his feet. Cronwell will hand it off to Franzen. Now Datsyuk across the line. Shot was blocked by Weber. Datsyuk again. Turns and hands it off to Franzen. Weber just knocks Datsyuk down with the puck recovered here by Franzen. He'll circle the Nashville goal. Turns on the backhand. It's blocked. And Radulov starts to back now for Nashville. Behind the play, Bertuzzi and Suter finally get untangled.
Yeah, Bertuzzi and Suter, that was a great shift. They're battling for position down low, away from the puck.
Lost the line now. Here is Datsyuk. Pulls up, sends it across far side. Good recovery by Erat on Filppula. Now Fisher. Off the stick of Erat, cleared by the wings the other way. Hudler is going to chase this one down. Trying to get away from Josi. Hands it off now to Filppula. Sends it back in deep. Zetterberg got position there on Klein, but then Klein ties him up. Now the puck comes free, and it's chipped off the boards. Erickson sweeps it in deep for Zetterberg. Sergei Kostitsyn lost it. Here's Hudler with a shot that's deflected up over top of the net. And Erat with it in front of that Detroit bench. A shove by Zetterberg. Now the puck comes free. Nashville making a change. Back to the late man into the zone as Eriksson with a shot here, and that was deflected just wide on the glove side of Pekarinen. Held in by Detroit. Zetterberg pulls up, looks to the front, sends it there, but it's deflected away by Rene. Now Quincy to the corner. Miller with it. Hands it off for Zetterberg. Back for Miller. Miller tried to get to the front. And Klein would have none of that. Then back in deep. Yip gets it for the Predators. Spins away from Hudler. And Klein angles it off the glass. Kept in by Quincy. Miller sends it deep. Not a time of possession here in the Nashville zone for Detroit. Emerton now is the fourth line. Finally, the line change is completed, but this puck is covered up by Pekarinen. Weber, a right-hand shooting defenseman, scored on the power play in the first, and then Klein, look at this nifty play. Getting through the Detroit defense, beating Jimmy Howard. It's 2-0, Nashville.
Suter and Weber are a real dynamic duo defensively. Their body position and their strength have a lot to do with. See how they trade off in the first period and work together in tandem. They sweep things in front of the net. They read plays well. Weber playing hard and physical along the wall against Datsyuk. You can't afford to give him an inch. Look in front of the net. Look at Suter. Play from the away from the puck matters. He knows Bertuzzi is strong. He knows Bertuzzi can score. So he stays on the inside of him, has perfect body position the whole time.
Brian Engblom, a former defenseman in the National Hockey League, speaking about the position that's played so well by those two from Nashville. As the Red Wings back the other way, here comes Datsyuk taking it wide. Pumps it in behind Rene, who got the stick on it, and now the Red Wings. Wanted to get to, we got a slash coming here as somebody lost the stick. And before we get to the call of the penalty, let's take a look at tonight's Ford update. Shea Weber, second goal of the series, first power play goal for the Predators, second career playoff goal for Klein, and Detroit's 6-0 all-time at home in the playoffs against Nashville. And that's
a great two.
It is.
That's Kevin Klein with the Mohawk. And we got Johan Franzen in the box for slashing. He whacked the stick out of the hand of Mike Fisher along the wall.
No power play number three for Nashville. They're 1-for-2 with a man advantage here this afternoon. Leguan angles it off the boards, chased down by Weber. Weber back to Leguan, back to the Nashville captain, but he was off balance there a bit. The Wings were able to pressure it out to center ice.
Oh, great stick by Weber, though, because he was dead in the water. If Miller drops that one by him, there's no way Weber turns and catches Miller.
As this puck is deflected up over the glass and out of play.
It's those little plays. Weber was trying to move into the middle of the ice and he got fooled. See how he's going the wrong direction, but he stops dead there. Look how good he is at staying on the puck there, because if he's not, he's done. Miller's got terrific speed. Weber just does a real good job there of jamming it. And Miller can't accomplish what he wants to. Chip it by him and chase it down.
Josi sends it across. Ellis. Urash tried to force it to the slot area. Predators recover, though. Here's Josi, still better than a minute remaining in the Detroit penalty. The Johan Franzen. Josi tees it up for a drive. Knocked down to the blue paint. Fisher is there. It's still loose. And now a whistle. I could see it, Brian, from my vantage point here. The pad of Howard was down, but it wasn't on top of the puck entirely. That's why we didn't get a whistle, and Mike Fisher and Martin Erat were jamming away at it.
Yeah, it's just a sea of humanity down here, and you can see the pile up at the end. Nice job by Ellis here. Look at that. Cool, calm rookie, and then the big shot by Josi. And then you got Fisher in there. You got Hornquist in there as usual. Hornquist is actually on the backside of the goaltender of Jimmy Howard for a second. That's his spot. He's the Thomas Holmstrom of the Nashville Predators. He's going to be in the paint all the time. And Howard knocked the first one down. And then Eriksson,
right,
good job. Good job by Eriksson, because Eriksson just cleaned Hornquist out of there. That's, you got to take a couple of licks in there if you're going to be successful. Nice job by Eriksson cleaning house.
Face-off control by the Wings. Runwell turns away, snaps it across for Filppula.
What a great play coming out of the zone. The control of Cronwall and then making the pass out in front of his own net because it's not dangerous. It's the right play.
But that pass has to have some pace on it, though, right, Brian?
You bet. It's got to be 100% right.
Now Suter. Hands it off in the corner, gets the return pass. Suter slides it across for Weber. 35 seconds still remaining in this Nashville power play. A chance to take a 3-goal lead on the road. Centering pass, and Howard was down, but the puck sent wide. Rattled off with leg one. Here's Andre Costitz, and another penalty coming to Detroit with still 23 seconds remaining.
Kyle Quincy.
Mike Babcock can't believe it over behind that Red Wing bench.
There have been quite a few cross-checking penalties in this series. Quincy with a shot from behind, that's zero tolerance there. His hands are split apart a little bit. Yeah, he does push him on the back, but I don't know. You should be able to push a guy on the back sometimes. There is zero tolerance right now, and Mike Babcock is letting his feelings be known right now. This is a dire situation for them. They can ill afford to give one up here on the 5-on-3. Big face-off here for Datsyuk.
Fisher wins it with some help from Erad, who got it back to the point. Now for Weber with a blast and a save made by Howard.
That's the perfect setup. Nice job by Radulov there to threaten going to the middle of the ice. But you got Weber inching down. One of the hardest shots in the National Hockey League. See Radulov pushing everybody deeper. Boom. Puts the puck in exactly the right place. And you know what? Shea Weber got a good shot away. But that wasn't the 105-mile-an-hour bomb that he can bring.
This time the draw controlled by Zetterberg, and the Wings able to clear it down to 10 seconds remaining in the 5-on-3. That's the time remaining in the Franzen penalty. Now Erad hits the line. It comes back to Weber, nearly intercepted by Zetterberg. Now Weber hammers one, and Howard the save just as Franzen comes out of the box. He'll skate over to the bench.
Shea Weber's got that presence thing going again that we talked about. He was just okay in the first two games. He was steady, but he didn't have that presence, that Chara-like kind of presence, that Pronger-like kind of presence. One of the things that he does use as a weapon is, in fact, that big shot. This one he got all of. He hit that one harder than he did that one-timer on the 5-on-3.
Wings control the draw, but Andre Kostitsyn able to get it away from Stewart. Now it comes back to the line. Josi with it. Back on the far side now for Ellis. He put it up too high on the glass. And it's recovered by Miller. He'll send it all the way back down the ice.
Just to sort of clarify that stuff about Weber that I was talking about, Dave, is that it's literally how you play. It's how you pass the puck. It's how you skate up the ice. It's your intent. It's how you look to your teammates. That's the part that I was saying that was just a little bit muted in the first couple of games. He didn't quite have that it factor because he has a gigantic presence when he plays angry and he's in that complete A1 mode.
Rattle off across the line. Angled to the boards by Erickson. Now Cleary. Able to spin away from the Nashville pressure. Plays it off the boards to himself nicely. Sends it all the way back down the ice. Picked up by Filppula. Sends it out front.
Great play.
Yep, Erad. Ian White couldn't control it. Here's Erad with it now. All four penalty killers back for Detroit. Now it comes back to the line. Weber keys it up. High shot that hit one of the players, maybe Cromwell in front.
Hornquist hit Hornquist in front. He'll talk to Weber about that one.
Yeah, exactly.
Hey, I'm one of yours.
Fisher tried to play it back to the point, but it was deflected, and the Wings get to it first and hammer it down the ice. Now Detroit survives 23 seconds of a 5-on-3 Nashville power play, and then the ensuing 5-on-4, the Wings are back at full strength. Hansen steps into Bork. Now around, it's held in by Klein. He tees it up for a shot that doesn't get through. And it's cleared by Quincy all the way back into the Nashville zone.
Klein would have been better off to use the lively boards on that shot. There were about 3,000 pairs of legs there between him and the net. There's no way that was getting through.
Icing call here as Johnson and Bouillon had to be separated a bit.
There's been some good defensive play by the top players of Nashville in this game, too. Cleary comes late on the play, tries to jump on this, and he has his step on Erat. Erat had looked over his shoulder, saw Cleary right there, perfect look at it, and he goes, whoops, I'm in trouble. Doesn't hesitate, sniffs it out, makes the play at the right time. If he doesn't dive at that time, chances are he's getting a penalty for hooking, or Cleary's getting a real good scoring chance.
Martin Erat twice representing the Czech Republic in the Olympics in 06 and in Vancouver in 2010. Now it's tipped by Bork in on Howard. He angles the puck off the end board. Lidstrom, Zetterberg, center ice for Hudler, who deflects it into the Nashville zone. Under 7.5 remaining here in the second period. As the Predators' Brandon Yip getting control, sends it out to center ice. Yip has it again for Legwon. Out of the reach of 2-2. Legwon getting a double shift here with a couple of the fourth line wingers. Zetterberg carries it on the backhand. Rolls it out front. And it's knocked away and cleared by the Predators. Now Lidstrom backing up. Nashville making changes. Here is Cleary. Sends it in deep. Abdelkader takes a look. Given a shove there by Bouillon, Abdelkader through traffic, and that bounce just wide. Here's Bertuzzi with it. He turns, rolls off his stick. Out to the line, taken by Cronwall. Cronwall's shot was blocked by Sergei Kostitsyn, and now it's lifted by Fisher, but not out of the zone. And now the Predators able to get it. Sergei Kostitsyn finds room to send it down the ice.
You see how quickly Nashville swarmed, though. When Cronwall kept that puck in, there were three white jerseys around him, and the Detroit Red Wings were kind of isolated.
Here's Cronwall with a chance. That missed the net. Now Cleary. Now before this series started, Detroit coach Mike Babcock, Brian, said that we have to be more physical in the offensive zone than we have been towards the end of the regular season when they struggled down the last 20 games. But they haven't had much time in the offensive zone, largely because they've been shorthanded.
Yeah, that's true. And so they lose a lot of their momentum. At key times, they keep losing it because of penalty kill. And they are wearing out some key players because of the penalty kill time they have to have.
Right through the goal mouth, that pass by Erickson. Here's Franzen picking it up, sends it back toward the Nashville goaltender who knocked it down. And back the other way now, Suter. That's broken up by Lidstrom.
Lidstrom's got that uncanny knack. That puck was about a foot in the air, and he knocked it right out of the air. Johan Franzen looks like he's going to get a penalty here. He took a shot at Radulov right in front of the bench.
We'll get the official call when we come back. 2-0 Nashville. Time now for Edward Jones FaceTime with Nashville Predators coach Barry Trotz. Here's Brian.
Barry, your defense have been very active in this series, and now you have two goals from your defense. Is that something you've been focusing on?
Well, the way you have to play Detroit, the game's changed. That fourth guy has to activate. You see that from a Detroit standpoint. You're going to see it from a Nashville standpoint. Detroit's all about numbers. We've got to join with our numbers as well.
Before you scored on the power play here today, were you worried about it?
No, not at all. We could have scored three or four power play goals the other day. And it was all about our finish. We had some great open looks and we didn't finish. But the chances were there. And we had some more great chances even in the first period where we didn't score. But finally we got that goal, and that was real huge for us.
Thank you.
All right.
Well, you saw at the end of the conversation there between Brian Engblom and Barry Trotz that David Legwon reached over and grabbed Johan Franzen. So there was a bench minor called on Nashville. And Franzen also called for a penalty. So four skaters aside, no power play here.
It's funny that Legwon is out there, though. Hornquist is the one in the penalty box, along with Franzen.
Here's Coppola now. Sends it back to the line. Lidstrom with a shot, and Pekarinen will just hold it there.
Yeah, there was a lot of action right as the last whistle went before we went to the commercial break. Started along the boards. There's Suter. Here comes Franzen. And Legwon with a little bit of a push there or whatever, and then Franzen was unhappy. That's where he's talking to the referees there, saying he pulled on my jersey, and it was Legwon. That was very, very kind of cute there of Legwon. He definitely got away with that, but it still ended up with a penalty.
Not quite as cute as Ryan Clough late in the regular season putting his stick on the ice to break up a rush while he was on the bench.
I wouldn't call that cute. That was wacky.
A steal. That's it!
Thank you.
in the National Hockey League. Josi tries to protect the puck, but Pavel Datsyuk is way too slick, way too smart. That is perfection. Look at the goaltender, Pekka. By the time he realizes that his defenseman is not coming back into his own view, he's got that uh-oh feeling, and it's too late. That is brilliant. A 1-2 punch with the stick, all legal, terrific stuff. That guy is a burglar.
Pavel Datsyuk either leads or is among the leaders in takeaways every year. A Selke Award winner is the best defensive forward, and of course we know what he can do offensively. And so an unassisted goal, 4-on-4. And it's got the Red Wings back to within one, back the other way. Now here comes Fisher with a shot that missed the net. And Nyquist getting a little bit of ice time here with Zetterberg, 4-on-4. I want to talk to the people that see the Red Wings every day about this Nyquist kid, that he has the skill to play with the world-class talent on Detroit as Lidstrom hands it off to Cromwell. Zetterberg goes in there to try to dig it out. There goes Kostitsyn, able to knock down Zetterberg and back the other way. Good pressure by Cromwell. That actually forced the play offside at the Detroit line. 4:07 remaining in the second. A 4-on-4 goal by Pavel Datsyuk has cut the Nashville lead in half.
There are a lot of nerves in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and especially for a rookie. And for Roman Josi, he's going to go through that for the next couple of shifts. He's the one that turned the puck over when Pavel Datsyuk stole it from him in behind the net. Datsyuk has done it to many guys, and his reaction afterwards was total disgust. Now he's got to control himself and get his head back in the game. Josi is a really good player. He's played some terrific hockey in his first 2-plus games this series.
Just 21 years of age, the native of Bern, Switzerland, Roman Josi. White slides it across. Here is Lidstrom, hammers the puck. Knocked down, and set just wide. Each team still with a man in the box for another 12 seconds.
Oh, killer instinct, Dave. Sorry, killer instinct. Pavel Datsyuk is jacked up. He made two great plays there. Neither one went in.
He had 97 takeaways this season to lead the National Hockey League once again. Now Hornquist sends it in wide. Now the teams are back at full strength. Lidstrom now for Datsyuk. Across the line, poked away by Bouillon, who timed it perfectly, as you have to do against number 13. Now Bork with it. Rides it along the end boards, looks for the return. He has it, tries a wraparound, and jumping out on that loose puck is Jimmy Howard.
Momentum, momentum, killer instinct. All those are the things that make you a great player and make the difference between winning and losing. Pavel Datsyuk just scored a brilliant goal. He comes right back on the next shift, and watch him in front of the net get this rebound. He gets it, and it just rolls off the toe. That was in, but he doesn't quit on the play. He threw it right back up the gut, and very nearly they ended up scoring on the second chance around. That's the kind of stuff. You keep your head in the game. You don't stand there when you miss the first opportunity on an empty net. You get right back to it and throw it out there. Two great plays by Datsyuk.
3 minutes exactly remaining in the second period. Again, remember the Detroit penalty kill, especially the 23 seconds of 5-on-3 that Nashville had when it was 2-0, and Predators really could have put this game away. Now Stewart. That's gloved down by Fisher and cleared out to center ice, but Stewart got a stick on it. And now he's got a back up. Here is Fisher with it, hands it off, and coming back was Applicator to the gate, Andre Kostitsyn. Now Bertuzzi pushes it out to center ice, but Fisher has it there. And Bertuzzi and Fisher go down, and Fisher's helmet comes off. The two of them are separated, and they're both going to go. And we're going to have some more 4-on-4 hockey.
Todd Bertuzzi has been a physical presence in this series. But don't underestimate Mike Fisher. This guy plays hard. He's got talent. He's got skill. He's up against the top forwards all the time. He's split it between Datsyuk and Zetterberg in this series. Here's the last play. Abdelkader on the back check. Brilliant back check to lift up the stick of Kostitsyn later on in the same process.
Here's Bertuzzi with a little bit of extra. And Fisher, who wasn't going to take any, he's the one who turned around on Bertuzzi and threw him down. The battle level of these guys is intense. It's the playoffs. And I think you expect that from Bertuzzi. He was a big, strong guy. He showed that when he fought Weber and the way he's played physically. Fisher is not known as much for it, but he doesn't shy away.
Well, four skaters aside as they each got 2 minutes for roughing here with 2:14 remaining in the second period. Nashville leading this game three by a score of 2-1. The draw controlled by the Predators. Luder slides it back in deep.
Everybody jockeying for position there. That was pretty interesting. White with good body position, and he wasn't going to let Erad get around that net.
Get live NBC National games right on your Verizon 4G LTE smartphone with Verizon 4G LTE NHL Game Center Premium. Call Star NHL to download today only from Verizon.
When you're in your own zone, body position means everything. You don't know when the guy you're covering is going to end up with the puck. And White was battling for every inch and knocked the net off.
Draw control by the Preds, and that Suter shot deflected by Legwand just wide. Here's Legwand with it again. The first ever draft pick of this Nashville franchise, and I mentioned earlier, a native of Detroit. Legwand hands it off in the corner. Erad comes up the boards with it. Knocked away by Zetterberg. Now across for White. White for Zetterberg. Zetterberg backhands it. A call! Redirected! Wide by Lidstrom, who was looking, I think, for a call.
He was being hooked a little bit from behind, I think, by Legwand, but I was still shocked that it never went in.
Now Zetterberg. Detroit has their only goal 4-on-4, and here's another chance for Franzen, but he famined it as he tried to sweep it in toward Pecorine. And back comes Erad. Canceled off now for Suter. Back to Erad. Hit shot, misses the net. Spalling gets to it. Now it comes out to the line. Bouillon's got some room. Steps into this one. It never got through. And Zetterberg will drop it back. 40 seconds remaining in the coincidental minor penalties. About 10 seconds more than that left in this second period of game three. Western Conference quarterfinals, Brian.
Detroit's got that look about them again, Dave. That really, since that Datsyuk goal and those couple of plays afterwards, they're different.
Datsyuk for Cleary. Spins away from Josi. Now Cleary goes back to Datsyuk. This is the guy Detroit wants to have the puck.
I love the way he stick handles on the backhand. He does that all the time. Almost nobody else does that.
Locked in front between the circles. Datsyuk trying to get to it. Nashville player went down, and Datsyuk went down over the top of the Nashville player. 15 seconds left in the period. Penalty coming against Sergei Kostitsyn.
Oh, yeah, for sure. He got his stick up really high there on Dan Cleary. Got him right up around the head and shoulder area. Cleary with a couple of words for him there. That's not a good penalty or a good time for Kostitsyn to take it.
Just as Fisher and Bertuzzi came out of the box.
Nashville's got to regain themselves, and right now they got to kill a penalty. Along the wall here, that was the shot from behind. You could see why Kostitsyn was angry. He got shoved from behind. Okay, so big deal. But you don't turn around and loop the guy around the neck with your stick blade, but the referees aren't going to miss that. That was the Lidstrom chance earlier. He was being hooked from behind. You could see Lidstrom going, hey, he got the shot away, but obviously not the one he wanted. It was a terrific play. And Legwand took the gamble of hooking him and got away with it.
Not much time left, but Detroit wins the draw. Lidstrom with a shot. What a save there by Pecorine. That's it with it again. 2 seconds remaining. Sends it to the front of the screen and they score! I believe time had expired. And Pecorine looks like he's a bit shaken up as Ryan Suter checks on him. The blue light came on.
This is going to be really close, there is no doubt. The initial shot from Lidstrom was a beauty, and Pecorine just goes down, sensing it's going to be low. His drop is perfect. They get it back in the paint. Look at the battle between Holmstrom and Pecorine. And he kicks it out, the rebound comes out, and they do put it in. Here's the clock.
Wow.
I don't think so. I don't think so. I think time had expired. I looked up and saw the blue light on as well, too. I think it expired.
Yep.
It's on zero right there.
And this clock, Brian, just so the folks at home know, because there's been some discrepancy at times, this clock that you are seeing burned into the monitor is the exact clock. The Situation Room in Toronto looks at the exact same thing. There has been some replays earlier in the season. I remember a situation at Madison Square Garden in New York where the clock that we were seeing on the TV and they were seeing on the in-arena big board was not exactly synced up to the official time, but boy, was this ever close. There you see it, 0.2. It disappears to 0.1. Puck's just coming into the frame, and there you see the zeros up, and the puck is inside the blue paint, and boy. And Pavel Datsyuk, Brian, I think for a split second, didn't realize how little time was left. Here's Tim Peel. What a finish to this second period. A sigh of relief from that man, Barry Trotz, to the Nashville Predators. They maintain their 2-1 lead. Coming up on the Discover Card, second intermission with Liam McHugh and Mike Milbury. Datsyuk works his magic and overtime thrillers in the first round. Don't we love overtime hockey and playoff time? Weber and Klein have scored for Nashville. Pavel Datsyuk has scored for Detroit. 40 minutes in the book. Red Wings on the power play to start the third period. The Discover Card second intermission. Welcome back to the Stanley Cup playoffs on NBC, presented by Geico. And there's Sergei Kostitsyn in the box. A little bit of frustration, Brian. We were talking during the break. He did not have a point the last 9 games of the regular season or a goal in the last 14 games. So that's quite an extensive period of time for him not to be productive offensively.
Yeah, so it adds to his frustration level. And he took a poor penalty. I mean, a retaliation penalty, wrapped his stick around the neck of Cleary. Yeah, he got pushed from behind by Cleary, but that's just a silly penalty there. And the whistle blew, the horn blew at the end of the period just in time for a lot of reasons, obviously to negate the goal. But on top of that, Nashville has got to regain themselves here. We got an ice issue here, I guess, down near the Detroit net. They've come out with a squeegee, and they're cleaning it up around Jimmy Howard.
Let's remind everybody now, you can check out NHL Extra on NBCSports.com and NHL.com for full DVR control of today's game, plus chat live with the experts from Pro Hockey Talk. Go to NBCSports.com or NHL.com to learn more.
Puck possession will be really big here. Detroit's going to try to pick up where they left off. They had a strong finish to that second period. They had a lot of momentum, very nearly tied it up. By 0.2 seconds, they missed it. Pavel Datsyuk really had his game going, and they'll be looking to pick it up here.
Well, these two goaltenders don't seem to mind the fact that there's no morning skate, and you start at noon. Look what they've done in day games. Pekka-Rinne and Jimmy Howard. Hockey players, Brian, are always, we talk about it, creatures of habit, as the Predators shorthanded, able to send this puck all the way down the ice. You played in playoff games. How much of a disruption is it to start a game at noon?
It is. It bothers some players more than others. That you are creatures of habit. You're used to going through your routine and eating at a certain time, pregame nap. Oh, the crowd wanted a hooking call against Datsyuk there. No call. But, yeah, it has an effect. But, hey, you get paid to adapt. You have to. That's the time the puck is dropped. You don't show up. The coach doesn't play it.
Here's Cronwall. Sends it to the front. I think Rinne got the blocker on that with Holmstrom right in his face. Here is Franzen with it straight away for Lidstrom. Winds up, hands it off. Quick centering pass, redirected just wide.
Nashville doing a good job of sniffing those out. Detroit did that a couple times early in the game, the quick play from the corner.
Oh, Suter did not get that puck out when he had a chance. Good stick, though, by Spaulding. What a recovery by number 13.
Oh, what a great play by Spaulding. That was a mental error there by Suter, who stole the puck, tried to go right up the gut with it. There's too many guys who will turn the puck over for you for Detroit, and Spaulding bailed out Suter.
Here is Zetterberg, wrist shot. And that is deflected wide by Pekka-Rinne, and now Fisher taken to the boards by Zetterberg. Klein wraps it around, Quincy hustles over, got a stick on it, but could not keep it in the zone. And we're down to the final 20 seconds remaining in the Sergei Kostitsyn minor penalty. A minute and a half into this third period. Leg one lifts it back, bouncing puck. Controlled now by Filppula. Predators power play goal, a first for them in this series. They're trying to win a playoff game at Joe Louis Arena for the first time ever. Down low, here is Coppola, sends it in front, a shot saved made by Rene. Back to White with a shot that was blocked as Kostitsyn, who served the penalty, blocked that one, but what an opportunity.
He's hurt too. Kostitsyn got right in the shooting lane. That was perfectly timed, perfectly positioned. That one hurt him.
That was a grade-A scoring chance before the shot blocked by Sergei Kostitsyn. As Bertuzzi plays it on the far side, Abdelkader carries into the zone, pushes it in deep, runs into Ryan Ellis. Here's Bertuzzi, centering pass, that's blocked by the Predators. Out to the line, Stewart sends it back in deep. Taken out by Cleary. Looks over his shoulder, sends it back along the boards, far side. Stewart moves in for the point. He's checked by Bork. Now Cleary makes the pass to the line, hangs onto it. Tried to get it to the slot area. That was broken up by Bouillon, who roughs him up. They continue to battle. Now it's gloved down by one of the Predators and sent across to the far side of the Nashville zone. Stewart rolls it back in deep for Bertuzzi. Bertuzzi working deep along with Cleary. Bertuzzi goes down, so does a Nashville player. And it comes to Jordan Tutu. He hands it off now as Bork sends it in deep.
With a full court press by Detroit is what we expected and what we're seeing. They got the advantage early in the period because of the power play and getting that feel with that extra man. And they've carried it on since the penalty expired.
Runs it across the line. Hands it off. That took a quick shot. Boy, he didn't miss by much. He was trying to go high against the grain.
He had Nyquist going to the net. Had there been any kind of a rebound, there would have been a chance.
Lidstrom. Shot fake out the Nashville player down, but now it's taken by Suter around the boards on the far side. Fisher looks out. Here comes Bronson. But it was out to center ice. The Predators able to clear. Erat drops it back. Weber jumps up. Holds on. Off the side of the Detroit net, and now Erat being played by Lidstrom. Walks it up the boards. First game of our Stanley Cup playoff doubleheader. Don't forget Pittsburgh-Philadelphia game three following our coverage here in Detroit. Andre Kostitsyn with a shot, and that was off the left pad of Jimmy Howard and just wide. Filppula, a dangerous stick handling area, and he's going to get away with it here as Lidstrom pushes it along. Lidstrom for Datsyuk. Pavel Datsyuk, who has the Detroit goal, hands it off Zetterberg. Across the line, and Filppula could not hold up. He was offside.
Well, there have been some scoring chances for sure. Let's go back to Ryan Suter trying to come out of his own end shorthanded and stick handling. You can't do that. That's got to go out, especially because you're shorthanded. And then later on in the sequence, that's where Spalling diving back there with Suter still trying to recover. That was a big play by Spalling. And then Detroit again on the attack. Pekka Rinne doing a real nice job there, making two key saves. Rinne very aggressive there. That second save, he was about 6-7 feet out above the blue paint.
That was Kyle Quincy that had that great chance before the shot block by Kostitsyn. And now here is Quincy off the stick of Filppula. And Klein, who right now has the goal that's the difference of the game on that terrific rush through the neutral zone, splitting the Detroit defenders. Here is Zetterberg with a shot into the glove of Rinne, and he will hold it there. Tonight, it's the toughest task ever, the Celebrity Apprentice Puppet Show. All new Celebrity Apprentice tonight at 9, 8 Central, right here on NBC.
Well, the shots are already pretty lopsided Detroit's favor, but that's certainly not unusual, and it's probably going to get worse if you're Shea Weber and the Nashville Predators. Barry Trotz talked about that. It's in Detroit's DNA to get everything to the net, and they will here because they're down.
Quincy tried to get that one to the net, but it never got through. Almstrom for Miller. Had to get it to the front. He did, and there it is again. Now, Pavel Datsyuk, I mentioned, Brian, has the only goal of this game, and again, he's been a factor.
You have to keep track of this guy all the time. Early on in the game, they were all over him. He didn't have very much room. Weber was all over him, stayed on top of him, but then he did this, steals it from Roman Josi, sticks it in on the short side, had another great chance, his next shift out immediately, one right there, threw it back out in the paint, and from that time on, Detroit really started to roll. We got a ruckus now in the corner.
It was Holmstrom for Detroit on the far side before the faceoff even took place. Jordan Tutu and Erickson have a hold of each other.
Nashville's on their heels here. There is no doubt. They're protecting the lead, and it's hard to get that balance right. Look off the left side of your screen there on the false start on the faceoff, and Holmstrom.
That's, yeah, and Bouillon. Yep.
Bouillon doesn't back away or back down. He's not a very big guy. But the result of all this is the faceoff comes outside of the zone, and that's a big thing. Mike Babcock, not a happy man because of that. Faceoffs are a huge part of any game.
That faceoff, kind of a neutral faceoff in the neutral zone, but finally Detroit takes possession and drives it in deep. Predators get it out to center ice, and Yip drives it deep into the Detroit zone. Erickson with it. Holmstrom drops it back. A lead pass here for Miller. He's got Everton coming late. Miller with a shot. Save, rebound! And that was saved by a couple of Nashville defenders who got back. That was a shot off the far pad, Brian, that became the perfect pass, didn't it?
Everything but in. I don't know if Jordan Tutu got his stick on it or who did. Somebody on the back check. But coming out of the zone, might have been Klein who got his stick on it. Wow, what a recovery there, because the breakout, everything was brilliant for Detroit, and then Klein robbed them.
Bouillon with it now, plays it ahead, and it deflects behind Howard, but they wave off the icing. Lidstrom plays it ahead, Datsyuk rolls it out to center ice. Bronson, Datsyuk follows up, slides it across. Here is White with it, he hammers a shot that misses the pad of Pekka-Rinne. Now Franzen out to the line. Lidstrom fakes the shot, settles it down. That's a save. Rebound chance for Nyquist. And now Pekka-Rinne is going to cover it up.
Detroit really starting to roll here. Let's see where all this goes, because the offense of Detroit is starting to roll.
The shots are now 31-18 Detroit, but Pekka-Rinne, the biggest reason, with some help, that Nashville still leads it.
Play by Detroit coming out of their zone as it goes around the wall to Holmstrom, who bunts it back to Quincy. Quincy on the fly, bumps it up to Miller on the fly. An outnumbered attack, the perfect shot off the far pad. Emerton has an open net. Watch Klein turn around. It hit the shaft of his stick, an empty net. The goaltender Pekka-Rinne with the thanks, buddy.
Yeah.
Put that stick in my Hall of Fame after that one.
Oh, Klein. With the goal, that's the difference right now, and the save, that's the difference in the game. With 13:29 remaining here in the third period of Game 3, this series tied at 1, Nashville leading this Game 3 2-1.
And it was Corey Emerton who scored that great goal in Game 2, top shelf on the short side, that made the biggest difference in the Detroit game. He could have been the hero there again.
Now Suter plays it ahead. Here is Weber. Deflected by Radulov, but recovered here by Cronwall. Slides it across for Stewart. Ederberg. Or Filppula across the line now for Hoedler. Drops it back to the line. Cronwall with a drive. That was blocked by Radulov. Filppula trying to spin to the middle. Knocked off his stick. Collides with Andre Kostitsyn. And now it's cleared all the way back down into the Detroit zone. Howard comes out to push it to Cronwall.
In Game 2, Mike Babcock said after Game 2, actually said, we sat back too much and we lost our speed protecting the lead. You can see a little bit of that from Nashville right now. It's hard to get it right. You protect the lead, you don't take chances, but you sit back too much and you keep giving them chances.
Well, if you can't get enough playoff hockey, we've got plenty coming your way here on the NBC Universal Networks, beginning with the second game of our doubleheader here on NBC at 3 Eastern, Pittsburgh and Philadelphia. Philadelphia trying to grab a 3-0 stranglehold in that series. New Jersey and Florida, just game 2 of that series. The Devils won the opener down at the Bank Atlantic Center in Sunrise. 7:30 Eastern on NBC Sports Network. And then later on tonight at 10:30 Eastern, Vancouver and Los Angeles. Lidstrom with a shot that sails over the glove of Pekka-Rinne. Sergei Kostitsyn, a couple of pops at it. Can't get it by Ian White, who jams it along for Franzen. Now Franzen trying to come out of the corner to make something happen here against Roman Yossi. Gets the center, cuts it down to, pulls it back, wait, now he shoots, and it's blocked in front of Rinne. Now it's knocked free. Nyquist goes to the front of the net. Here's Franzen. He drops it back now for Lidstrom, sends it across. Dean White with a shot that's blocked up high in the air. Hammered off the boards, and now Lidstrom gets to it. Josi will chase it down, and it's finally deflected by the Predators all the way back. Now, this is going to be icing. The Nashville players were trying to make a change, but the linesman will sort this out and get those players for Nashville back on the ice.
Watch this play out of the corner by Franzen. He's protecting the puck. He's looking at Datsyuk. They're figuring out the timing here. And watch this. That is brilliant. He knows where Datsyuk is going to go. Datsyuk goes to the spot. You pass to the spot, and it ends up in a scoring chance. Nashville was in scramble mode. That's chemistry.
You know, I mentioned that Nyquist has the ability to play with the high-skilled guys like Datsyuk, and he was out there with those guys. Bertuzzi now playing with Advocator and Cleary. So Mike Babcock changing things up just a little bit, Brian.
Yeah. Well, you know, you got to try and get a different feel. Sometimes it's about penalty. Sometimes it's about fatigue. We never know who's banged up on top of things, too. But penalty, we see the goaltender cover the puck up here, but fatigue becomes a factor here, too.
This week, don't miss the Stanley Cup playoffs presented by Geico on the NBC Sports Network. Every game, every night. Then on Saturday, be the first to see your favorite Notre Dame stars in the Notre Dame Blue Gold Game. And in 2 weeks, the Izod IndyCar Series continues with the Sao Paulo 300, all on the NBC Sports Network. Wincy through traffic. That did get through to Rene. He made the stop. Shots piling up in favor of Detroit, but keep in mind, Pecorine, he likes it better when he faces 35 or more shots. Advocator,
Hornquist. Hornquist just got hung up on the net in the Detroit zone. The Detroit net is way off its moorings. Hornquist tried to take the shortest route around the back of the net, and it was a little too short. Look at the nets all askew there. He could have hurt himself there. Those nets don't move that easily. Prior to that, Detroit, Quincy from the point. Rene's got that great sixth sense about it. Here's Hornquist on the attack. He leans in and,
oh, wow.
It's that center post. He leaned in so much. He got that center post. Looks like he's all right.
12-0. The shots on goal favoring Detroit so far here in the third period. 9 minutes and 1 second in. The faceoff win by Gostad.
Yeah, the puck possession has got to be bothering Barry Trotz and the Nashville Predators now. Way too much of it for Detroit.
Now Zetterberg plays it ahead. Hudler able to get it to Filppula across the line. He waits for reinforcements coming in. It was knocked to the ice by Suter, sent to the side of the net, knocked away by Rene. Hudler trying to get to it. He's tied up there by Klein. Hudler finally gets his stick free, then kicks the puck along the board. Now Klein getting some help from Leguan. A two-on-two battle along the board. Puck comes free at Zetterberg. Turns, sends it to the front, goes off a skate. And it pops out onto the stick of Radulov, who plays it back the other way for Andre Kostitsyn. Stewart runs into him. Now Franzen across the line. Fakes the shot, then lost the puck. Cleared by the Predators. Exactly halfway through this third period. Franzen with it again. Sends it to Nyquist. Knocked off of his stick, and it's out to center ice for Martin Erat. Hands it off now for Sergei Kostitsyn. Immediately taken back by Detroit and hoisted by Datsyuk with the backhand. As Josi moves it quickly for Shea Weber. He lobs it out through center ice. Knocked down by White. The Predators regroup. Weber lays it ahead. It rolls down behind Howard. Going to be icing if Detroit touches it first, but it's negated. Big hit by Erickson on Bork. You've got to be careful now, Brian, in a one-goal game. We've not had a minor penalty called in the third. And remember that power play that Detroit started this third period with was as a result of that late second period penalty.
Yeah.
Here's a loose puck in front. Corey Emerton moving in between the circles. It rolls just out of his reach, and it's chopped by the Predators back into the Detroit zone.
Terrific job there by Bouillon. That was Bouillon who dove and whacked it out of the zone. The problem for Nashville right now is, yeah, you're defending. You're on your heels all the time. If Detroit scores to tie it up, how all of a sudden do you step on the gas when you need some offense?
Now Quincy plays it ahead. It's blocked at the Nashville line all the way back into the Detroit zone. Radulov's going to get to this puck. He's onside. Radulov, wrap around. And that's knocked down in front before it got to Howard.
That was a good stick by Stewart there. Otherwise, Radulov had the right shot. Jimmy Howard was down.
Poked along the boards by Stewart. Leg one there for the Predators. Andre Kostitsyn out near the blue line. Backhands it along for leg one. Leg one toward the net. Howard, first save of the period. And a loose puck sliding back is Quincy. And he's able to glove the puck ahead to Todd Bertuzzi. Well, the Predators finally getting some time in the Detroit zone, but the puck lifted away by Abdelkader out to center ice. A. Weber. Puck deflects onto the stick of Erad across the line. Gets it back from Fisher. Send it to the side of the net. Howard stopped that. Here is Fisher with it again. Sends it out to the line. Yossi with a drive and a save by Howard. And it can't be easy to sit back there as long as Howard has without facing a shot like that. Now Filppula with it. Hits the late man White. Sends it wide. Greene, even with his long reach, couldn't quite get to that puck. He wanted to cover it with a glove. Just inside the Nashville blue line, Sergei Kostitsyn sits down on the puck, tries to glove it out of the zone. But it's backhanded back in deep behind the Nashville goal. Rene, that bounced off a Detroit player. Wraparound stop by Rene, got his goal stick on it. Now it comes in front, Lindstrom with a shot. Save, rebound chance. And it's set back in front between the circles, and the Predators got to it, able to clear.
Fatigue factor starting to be big for Nashville. You can tell their legs are getting shorter, and they're spending way too much time on their own end.
Bouillon wrapped it around. It's blocked by Filppula. Shuffles it along now for Zetterberg. Behind the Nashville net. Angles it out smartly to White, who whips it across for Lidstrom. Lidstrom hammers it off the lively boards here at Joe Louis Arena. Bounces all the way out to White. And that was blocked by Erad. And Nashville got a little bit of a break that White didn't hold that puck in. Lidstrom for Zetterberg. Zetterberg cruising along the board. Takes a look to the front. Still has it. The backhand centering pass was blocked, and Bouillon now with it. We'll play it ahead. It's deflected by the Predators into the Detroit zone. Erickson back to get it. Two Predators on hand, and the puck comes loose, covered up by Detroit goaltender Jimmy Howard, who has not been very busy here in the third, facing only two Nashville shots, but it remains the Predators up 2-1. The Joe Louis Arena. Let's take a look at our Lexus competitive edge, the ice time for the two captains, Shea Weber of Nashville, Nick Lidstrom of Detroit. Weber nearly 23 and a half minutes, Lidstrom just under 21 minutes. Pretty typical for them. Again, as we mentioned during game two, though, Lidstrom not killing penalties anymore because of that bruise that he has on his leg, not risking taking another puck to that same area. And a block shot is a reason that Hal Gill hasn't played yet in this series. He blocked a shot from Sheldon Surrey of the Dallas Stars in the next to last game of the regular season on the last shift he played in that game. As Quincy out of his own zone. 5.5 remaining here in the third. Pecorine hangs onto this one.
Pecorine has been one busy man, 38 shots on goal now for him. He has an uncanny sense of when to get down. At 6'5", when his pads are down on the ice, he covers everything. It's the shots from the point. He comes across and smothers you. But I think it's those ones that come through so many bodies that just are astounding. I watched the Detroit coaching staff before game two, watching Rene in the warm-ups, and how intense he was and how quick he was. And I saw them just looking at each other and talking to each other saying, look, basically, look how quick the guy is.
Yeah, you'll hear coaches and goaltending coaches talking about they want their goalies to play big. You don't have to tell Pecorine that. Barry Trotz was saying, even when he ends up deep in his net, he's still big.
He seems impossible to beat down low.
Jimmy Howard has to handle that long shoot in from center ice. 5 minutes remaining here in regulation time. Nashville continues to lead it 2-1. This series tied at a game apiece. They'll go at it again here at the Joe Louis Arena on Tuesday night. We'll have that for you on CNBC. As it comes down to Holmstrom with the backhand shot. A save made by Rene. Lidstrom following up. Got a stick on it, but couldn't get a shot away. end up the boards, but held in by Franzen. He slides it across now to White. Challenged by Radulov, but sends it in deep. One-handed to the slot area. Andre Kostitsyn there, and he got enough on it to clear it out to center ice. Now it's picked up by Legwand. He just sends it back in deep. Remember, Detroit came within less than a tenth of a second of tying this game in the dying second of the second period. Zetterberg off the pad of Rene. Now Filppula knocks it free. It's directed out to Cromwell. The point for a shot. A save made by Rene. Cromwell again poked away by Rene as he tracks that puck with such intense focus. Even through all the traffic he has to deal with. Now Weber just bouncing this one down, and that puck's not going to go far enough for icing.
That's 40 shots now on Rene. Wouldn't shock me if it was 50 before this is all over. Pucks coming everywhere.
Cromwell, that is stopped by Rene. And Fisher slides it ahead. Could be a two-on-one here. Sergei Kostitsyn waits. He shoots. He scores! Sergei Kostitsyn with 3.5 remaining. And regulation has given Nashville a two-goal lead, and the full court pressure, as you called it, Brian, for Detroit never paid off, and finally they gave up an odd man rush.
The guy who hasn't had a point in 11 games, Sergei Kostitsyn, makes you wonder if he really wanted to shoot the puck. Cronwall was the guy who shot the puck there, so the defenseman is caught. Filppula gambles at the blue line. That's what causes the outnumbered attack. Stewart plays in the middle. Kostitsyn doesn't have the pass. He makes the right choice. He pulls the trigger. His advantage, he's a left-hand shot on the right wing side. He gets a good angle to the net. He snapped that one. It looked like it went under Jimmy Howard's arm. Kostitsyn's looking for the pass. Yeah, it went right underneath the arm of Jimmy Howard. And boy, talk about a pressure release here on this Nashville side of the bench.
Well, a lot of firsts for Nashville in this game. The first goal of the series for Sergei Kostitsyn, as you saw. They've scored their first power play goal of this series. And they're trying again to win at Joe Louis Arena in the playoffs for the first time. They managed it once here during the regular season. It was the final meeting between the two. And the first time that both teams were fairly healthy, as this shot by Advocator doesn't miss by much. Now Cleary turns. Boy, this building as loud as it's been at times. Very quiet. And Mike Fisher got an assist. Here's a chance right in front of Pecorine. And Fisher, who did not have a point in the regular season series, breaks that drought against the Red Wings.
Well, you knew that Nashville wasn't going to get very many scoring chances because they were in their own zone. They got that one chance. You have to make it count. That was a terrific shot by Kostitsyn. A couple of mistakes there. Filppula not filling in for Cronwall. When Cronwall jumped up in the play, he grambled at the blue line, and that set up the outnumbered attack.
You know that Mike Babcock, again, is not going to be happy with the number of penalties this team has taken. I mean, Nashville right now has 4 power plays. They had them all, though, Brian, in the first 30 minutes of the game. And, right. And that's more than a game full by the average in the regular season for this Detroit team. And you see how effective they can be 5-on-5.
Right, there's no doubt. And Nashville got puck possession. They got a power play goal, so that got them off the schneid. And that was all early in the game. And it took...
odd man rush here, and it's fired just wide by Legwand.
It took Detroit out of their rhythm, and it took them a while to get that going.
Howard goes to the bench. Extra attacker coming for Detroit. They're down by 2 with a minute 45 remaining here in the third period. As Datsyuk slides it across. Here's Yuri Hudler centering pass. It didn't get to Filppula, and it's sent down the ice wide, but a whistle had blown a holding call. And it's going to be against Nashville.
David Legwand very slowly making his way to the penalty box, so they're going to finish off this game shorthanded. Down in the corner, just a little bit of a tweak.
18:23 of the third period, the first minor penalty of this third. And a timeout being called by the Detroit Red Wings. Tim Peel, the referee, indicating Detroit timeout. So with the goaltender pulled, it'll be 6 skaters against 4. Nashville, of course, can ice the puck in this situation. There's still a lot of time, Brian, if Detroit can get something here in the first 30 seconds or so of this power play.
Faceoffs will be huge. There's no doubt about that. And Pavel Datsyuk, who's one of the best in the business, he'll be out there. They'll also have Zetterberg, too, because it's a power play, but also he's very good in the faceoff circle, too. So it looks like Gostad's getting ready for Nashville to get out there. He was terrific in key situations in game one with the game on the line. In fact, he won two consecutive huge draws in his own zone.
He's won 11 out of 18 so far here this afternoon. He's a left-hand shooter, but very often he'll turn the stick around and take the draw as a righty. If the faceoff is to the right of Pecorine, it's now to the left. But he's just very tough in that faceoff circle, as is Datsyuk, and they will go head-to-head here with a minute 37 remaining in regulation. Red Wings end up winning the draw. Back to Cronwall. Hands it off on the far side for Zetterberg. Zetterberg sends it to the front. Picked up right back to Zetterberg. That was blocked, and the Predators able to clear it off the far boards back into the Detroit zone. Cronwall with it. Feeds it on the far side for Franzen. Minute 15 remaining here in regulation time. Now it comes out to the line for Lidstrom. Goes to Zetterberg. His shot missed the net. Holmstrom was screening. Franzen there as well. Now Lidstrom jams it along, but it's knocked down by Weber and out to center ice. Less than a minute remaining here in the third period. Zetterberg waits, shoots, scores! And there's still 51.9 seconds remaining in regulation.
Goal scorer's goal. Zetterberg's got great hands. They take the zone, as they're so good at doing. Zetterberg, left-hand shot on the right wing side. He sees that Pecorine goes down. But even though he's a tall goaltender, you see how he's looking in the middle of the ice, too. Goaltenders read the eyes of the shooters. Maybe he got Rene just glancing aside for a moment. Only Rene knows. But Zetterberg made the terrific shot. Looked like right off the top of the shoulder of Pecorine. Terrific shot by Zetterberg.
Second goal of the series. Both have been on the power play for Henrik Zetterberg. Now Detroit is going to try to take a page out of the Chicago Blackhawks' late third period playbook. Chicago has scored in the last 10 seconds in both of their games of their series against Phoenix in forced overtime, as this puck gets deflected up into the seats and out of play.
When goal scorers come in like that and they're looking away, Rene has to honor that. Is Zetterberg going to make a play into the middle of the ice? His anticipation has to be there, because it might be a one-timer. It might be a lot of things. And then all of a sudden, boom, the quick release, perfect, right up under the bar, glanced off the top of the shoulder. Watch Zetterberg. See, he's looking in the middle of the ice. I don't think he's even looking at the net there when he pulls the trigger. He's still looking in the middle. That may have frozen Rene just for a second. It's a great shot.
That was a great look at the eyes of that man, Henrik Zetterberg, looking to the middle and shooting it back the other way. 49.2 seconds remaining. The faceoff is at the center ice dot.
This will be full court press, everything into the paint, all the bodies in red get there.
Another huge face-off win, this time by Fisher. It's dumped back into the Detroit zone. Well, the Wings have to come 200 feet. Lidstrom pokes it ahead, Datsyuk gets it in, Howard goes to the bench. Rene settles it down, Suter wraps it around, and it bounces all the way down the ice, but it was deflected by a Red Wing, so no icing here. That's a huge break for the Nashville Predators. Now it's dumped in wide of Rene. Under 20 seconds remaining in regulation. Suter pushes it along. It's blocked along the inboard. Recovered by Detroit, but pushed away to the far side. Now to the front. It's blocked, cleared around, and nobody on the near boards for Detroit. And time is going to run out. The Nashville Predators are going to take a 2-1 lead by winning for the first time at the Joe Louis Arena in a playoff game. All three games in this series have been 3-2 finals. Nashville winning games 1 and 3, and Detroit's win came in game 2. 3-2 Nashville wins this game 3 to take a 2-1 lead in the Western Conference quarterfinal. Stay with us. We'll be back here to wrap it up at the Joe Louis Arena. You're watching the NHL on NBC.